Hello friends, welcome back to my another blog. From video title you might have already guessed, today I'm going to talk about how to become a software engineer in India. Yes, in this video I am going to explain you what qualification you need, what are the subject you should select, and how much percentage you should have. I'm going to explain everything, so watch this video till the end. I'm sure you'll be pretty clear and you should be able to take your own decision. So now let's start. So what kind of work software engineer do, or what is the work of a software engineer? In simple word, a software engineer's work is to develop a software, that's all. Now if you don't know what is software, let me explain you what is software in very simple way. So nowadays everyone has a smartphone, right? So when you purchase a new smartphone, you can see only few, when you first time open your smartphone, you can see only few applications are installed, right? But what we do after that, immediately we go to app store, we download whatever applications we need, like first we go and we download Facebook, I need Facebook application, I go and I install it. I need WhatsApp application, I go and install WhatsApp application. I install Twitter, I want any banking applications. So all these applications we install, all these applications are nothing but a software. So again, softwares can be different kind of softwares. Not only mobile applications are only software. We have like web applications also are a kind of software. If you open your laptop, if you open your browser, and if you type like www.google.com, it will open Google page. www.amazon.com, it will open your Amazon page, and you can purchase something, right? So these websites are also kind of software. Again, we have desktop applications. And the desktop applications also are kind of software. Like if you are a Windows user, you know about Notepad, you know about WordPad or Microsoft Word, Excel. All these are nothing but the software, desktop application softwares. Again, we have software like embedded application. Now question is, how to develop a software? So to develop a software, first you have to learn a programming language. So we have a lot of programming languages like C, C++, Java, Python, C#, etc., etc. So any of this language you have to learn.
Good morning guys, video was getting bored, so I thought of giving a break to this video. I'm going for workout, I'll be back from there and we'll start recording rest of the part of this video.
Welcome back. Now we'll talk about qualification required to get a job in an IT company as a software engineer. First of all, you should have a bachelor degree from any technical background like BTech, BE, MCA, BCA, MTech. So if you have any degree between these, you are eligible to get a job in an IT company. Now if you want to get a bachelor degree, or if you are in 11th or 12th class student, you might be thinking which degree you should select. So if you want to become a software engineer, definitely you should go for a BTech degree, because BTech degree is especially for software engineers, where you will be learning everything about software engineer. You will be learning how to develop an application, you will be learning end-to-end development, you will be learning life cycle of a software, you will be learning everything. Now if you are not qualified for BTech degree, then definitely you can go for a BCA. BCA degree also is for application development, you can go for BCA. Now if you are doing BCA, you make sure you are completing MCA also. Because only with BCA you are eligible to get a job in India but not in abroad. In future if you are thinking to go abroad, or if you get an opportunity to go abroad, you will be not qualified only with BCA. You should have MCA to get a job in outside of the India. Do not select BE because in BE you will be learning all about electronics. Yeah, definitely if you are interested in electronics, definitely you can go for BE, but for software development, BE is not the good option. Now we'll talk more about BTech degree because BTech degree is very popular and every IT company prefers BTech degree. To get a BTech degree, you should have physics and mathematics in 12th class. When you are in 12th, prepare for JEE exam. So if you don't know what is JEE, let me tell you that JEE stands for Joint Entrance Exam. Every year, end of March or first week of April, this exam happens all over the India. You have to get a very good score and you have to bring a very good rank in this exam. Because based on the rank, you are going to get admission in top level of institutes. In India, at the top level, we have an institute called IIT. Means Indian Institute of Technology, like IIT Kanpur, IIT Bombay, IIT Kharagpur, etc. etc. So like this, in India we have total 23 institutes. So if you are getting an opportunity in IIT, your future is bright because most of the big IT giants prefers IIT students. If you don't get admission in IIT, you have second level of institutes called NIT. Again, NIT stands for National Institute of Technology. This institute also very good, like NIT Durgapur, NIT Jamshedpur. So in India we have total 32. So in India we have total 32 NIT institutes. Again, if you don't get an admission in NIT, you can try for IIIT, Indian Institute of Information Technology. In India we have total 18 IIIT colleges. Now in India, IIT, NIT, IIIT, all these institutes are top level of institutes. So if you don't get admission in any of these institutes, we have lot of other institutes, you can take admission there. Also we have few private colleges, but the private colleges definitely going to expense little more. Now once you complete your BTech degree, you can go and apply for a job in any IT company in India. Now let's talk about the students who are below average. Like we have lot of students who don't have very good score in 10th or 12th. Even many students don't have science background but still want to become a software engineer. Remember, if you don't have very good score and if you don't have science, then you make sure you are very good in problem solving. If you have very good problem solving skills, then only plan for software engineering course. After 12th, what you can do, you can go for a diploma course. 1 year and 2 year, and along with this you can go for a degree called BCA. BCA stands for Bachelor in Computer Application. So you can do this. To get admission in BCA, many institutes do not require science background, only they will check your diploma degree. So if you are a diploma holder, you have an option to get admission in BCA course. Again, once you do your BCA, again you can do your MCA also, and you will not have any
problem to get a job in IT company.
Alright guys, hope I have covered pretty much everything. If you have any doubts, please share with me down comment section below. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you receive instant notification of my videos. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.